Welcome back. The countdown is now on until the November midterm elections, and all eyes are on Arizona, where voters will elect the state's first female senator. Democrat Kyrsten Sinema is running against Republican Martha McSally. Last hour, we were joined by Martha McSally, and now we're joined by her Democratic opponent, Kyrsten Sinema. Thank you very much for joining us.
It's great to be here with you.
You know, I talked about the historic factor of being all female. Has that set in, and what kind of pressure does that put on you?
You know, I don't really think much about whether I'm going to be the first woman or first anything. What I'm really focused on in this campaign is making sure that I'm delivering results for Arizonans. And, you know, there's a lot of challenges that everyday families are facing in Arizona, and that takes up all of my time and energy, just making sure we're serving them.
I know it's hard not to look at the gender factor in here, especially when you have a huge movement known as the Me Too movement. I want to read this to you. Yesterday, Melania Trump was asked about the Kavanaugh and Ford incident and the whole nomination process. When asked about who she believes, she said she stands with women. However, if women come forward, they must show proof. Your response to that?
Well, I believe women. Right now in our country and around the world, many women are facing just really difficult times in terms of remembering and experiencing sexual assault, sexual harassment. And I believe that those incidents are always wrong. And individuals who engage in that behavior do not deserve our public trust. So I believe women when they are brave and take the difficult step of sharing their stories.
Let's talk about the numbers here. The latest poll numbers out yesterday show that Martha McSally seems to be surging a little bit. Your thoughts on the latest numbers?
Well, there are polls coming out every single day, but you don't need a poll to know what you feel when you're talking to Arizonans on the ground. And as you were with us just last night, I've been visiting campaign offices around the state with literally hundreds of people who are coming to volunteer. We feel very good about where the campaign is right now because we're laser focused on answering the issues and the concerns that everyday Arizonans face.
And when you talk about the numbers out there, yesterday, here in the state, we learned the numbers of those who are registered. We learned that 1.2 million Republicans have now registered, and the gap seems to be closing with 1.1 million Democrats. What does that tell you about the race and the current state of politics here in the state of Arizona?
Well, I think Arizonans are hungry for practical leadership, and they're looking for someone who isn't really a very partisan person. So they don't really care as much about Democrat, Republican, or independent. They're looking for someone who shares their independent values, someone who will stand up for them and not just do what party bosses tell them to do. I think you're seeing that in this change of voter registration and the excitement that we hear from voters all across the state.
The race seems to have turned nasty a little bit with all the political ads out there. Is that the current situation in politics now, and is that necessary?
It doesn't have to be that way. You know, Martha has chosen to run a very negative campaign based on lies and smears and very personal attacks against me, and that's her choice. But our campaign is focused on talking about the issues that everyday Arizonans face. It seems to me that Martha doesn't want to talk about the issues because her vote record is a record that hurts Arizonans. But our campaign will stay focused, laser focused, on the issues that matter to everyday Arizonans, like healthcare access, education, taking care of our veterans, ensuring Arizonans have good jobs. That's the work that our campaign's going to keep talking about, and that's the work that I'm going to stay focused on.
Can you respond to some of these ads? Because they're hard to avoid. I mean, they are on every second of the day, and after a while, they become ingrained in your head, and people are listening to this. Do you care to respond to any of the accusations made against you?
Well, it appears that their campaign has just become increasingly desperate and are lodging all sorts of kind of crazy, outrageous attacks against me. But what we do know is that fact checkers have repeatedly called out those ads for lying. And we think Arizonans are smart enough to tell the difference between the truth and a lie.
Your platform is healthcare.
That's right. Let's
talk about healthcare, because a lot of health experts who I've spoken with say until you get those providers and the insurance companies to bring the cost down, all we're doing is putting Band-Aids on this. Do you have your plan, and what is it?
Well, there are important things that we can do to keep costs down for consumers, but the most important thing that Arizonans are worried about right now is the potential loss of protections for pre-existing health conditions. Last year, Congress passed a bill through the House, Martha supported it, voted for it, that if it had passed to the president, would have taken away protections for pre-existing conditions, which means people who have asthma or diabetes would pay more or not even be able to get coverage if they had one of those pre-existing conditions. The good news is we fought that back and have protected that. But that's an example of the kind of work we have to do to protect those existing provisions in our healthcare law to make sure costs don't go up even more.
She has called that a flat-out lie, the ad campaign, saying that she was not standing up for Arizonans with pre-existing conditions.
Well, we can take a look at the facts. We took a vote last year. I voted no on the piece of legislation that would have repealed that provision in law, and Martha voted yes.
We've talked about our veterans here. I know they're near and dear to your heart, as
yes.
they are Ms. McSally's. How do we fix the problem as opposed to just running in circles and doing the same thing over and over again?
Well, you remember when the new scandal broke about the Phoenix VA allowing 40 veterans to die while receiving care, I didn't wait for Congress to take action. I started working right then and there with community providers to help provide care for veterans outside the VA because the VA wasn't able to do the job. Now, since that time, I partnered with John McCain to pass several pieces of legislation, such as the CHOICE Act, that allow veterans to go outside the VA to get their care if they need it. That's been working better, but there's still a lot to do. And Arizonans know that this is very personal for me. With two brothers who served in the military, plus my stepdad and my grandpa, I take this very seriously, and I'm not going to let up until the VA provides the care that is needed for our veterans and that we're ensuring they can get care in the private community when that's the appropriate action.
Well, we thank you very much for taking the time.
Thanks.
We know your schedule is very busy, and we wish you the best of luck.
Thanks so much.
All right.